Welcome to the Mile High Podcast. This is your host, Dr. Daniel Knowles. I am super excited to have you join us today, and I'm looking forward to seeing everybody rising up to Mile High August 16th to 19th. If you are listening to this on iTunes or Stitcher or YouTube or whatever way you may listen to it, reminder, hit subscribe. We'd love to have you not miss any episodes because we put out great content each week to help you serve more people, impact more lives, and change more spines. So today, we're grateful to have as on our episode, Dr. Billy Chow, all the way from Australia. Now, Dr. Billy Chow is the vice president. Am I getting that right?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. I want to make sure I say it. Yeah. And the vice president of the Australian Spinal Research Foundation. So we're going to be talking about the ASRF. We're going to be talking about research. And we are going to be talking about Mile High because this year, all year, we've been highlighting the ASRF. And at Mile High coming up, we're going to be highlighting it. And we're grateful for Dr. Billy Chow flying out from Australia all the way to Mile High to be able to share about the ASRF and the incredible projects they're doing. So welcome to the Mile High Podcast, Dr. Billy Chow.
Thank you very much, Danny. I'm very, very, very happy to be here.
And we're very happy to be here now and also to see you at altitude. We'll see how that goes.
Yeah.
Have you been to Colorado before?
No, I've never been to Colorado.
Wow.
And when I, like, you know, for an Australian, like, you know, that hasn't been to Colorado, when you sort of said, come to Mile High. See, in Australia, Mile High, you know, we don't have that. So we think that maybe it's, you know, that's something to do with, like, on a plane.
Yes.
But then I Google searched it and I found out that because of the altitude that you're a mile high, the air's a bit thinner, you know, the oxygen's not so rich up there. So I'm hoping to do some altitude training up there.
Yeah, well, I would suggest it. I always suggest people, Colorado is such an incredible place to visit that when you come out, make sure you enjoy your time, you visit areas. Make the most out of it. You know, just even one day, you'll get to see incredible scenery. So let's start talking about the Australian Spinal Research Foundation. Yep. First and foremost, when did the ASRF form, and how long have they been around?
So since they started in 1977, so obviously been around for about 40 years. Originally, it was a group of very, very passionate chiropractors who sort of had an idea. And over the years, we've done, we facilitate and fund research. I would say that we're probably the largest chiropractic research foundation around, and we punch well above our weight. So our money that comes in generally comes in from just donations and memberships in the profession. And over the last, say, 40 years, we've funded over 200 projects and funded over $2 million worth of research.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's $2 million over 40 years.
Yeah. Look, if you divide it over the years, it doesn't seem like a lot. But as I said to you before, we are generally only at the moment funded by members in the profession.
No, I think that's amazing and phenomenal and needs to continue. And that's why I want to support, your movement. We are not in danger of having too much chiropractic research.
No.
But by any means. So we need more of it. So, and why Australian? Do you only do research in Australia or tell me about that?
Yeah. And obviously, back in 1977 when it first started, we weren't so global. And so the name obviously had stuck. It's the Australian Spinal Research Foundation. However, we do research and we fund and facilitate research globally. So, we've done research that has reached, far beyond just the borders of Australia. When people ask this, I kind of sort of use the example of an American Express card. Like I have an American Express credit card, but I'm an Australian. Yeah, it's fully it's not called the Australian Express card.
They don't rebrand it.
Mine
will work there.
Yes, absolutely, absolutely. In the same way that the ASRF funds research, globally. And the same thing with American Airlines. I can catch an American Airlines plane from Adelaide to the US. So that does come up a lot. You know, people sort of say, yeah, hey, you know, why should I back, you know, your foundation? I'm in the US, or why should I back your foundation? I'm in England. We are only Australia by name, but we are a foundation that takes care of research globally.
So let me ask you this. I don't know much about how they choose projects. I know there's a board, right? And there's officers.
Yes.
And
yep.
I know there's a clinical yep. advisory panel. How do they determine what projects to fund and facilitate?
Yeah. Well, at the ASRF, we have a very, very robust and unique process for how we vet and how we look at, you know, what projects we fund and facilitate. So it's a two-step process. So we have a CAP, which is a clinical advisory panel, which your wife, Rochelle, is part of. We have academics and chiropractors from around the world. What's that? Is that coffee?
It's iced coffee.
Iced coffee, yeah. Oh,
yes, good. Iced coffee with almond milk.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Though I heard that the coffee in Australia is better, but...
Yeah, it is better, but you know, like... Yeah, so we have the clinical advisory panel. So we every year we go out to the community, go out to a global community of researchers, and ask for them to present expressions of interest, so EOIs. So these EOIs then come in and they go through the CAP, the clinical advisory panel. Then the clinical advisory panel will have a look at whether these projects fit within our research agenda. You know, so you know, if it's to do with subluxation, absolutely. If it's to do with, you know, a clinical aspect to how chiropractic can can benefit function of the body, global well-being, quality of life, then absolutely. Or if it's sort of like a basic science type of research where it looks at looking at the definition and looking at vertebral subluxation, the impact of it. So that gets vetted into the CAP, and then from the CAP, these EOIs then get shortlisted, and then they go to the research committee, which then decide whether we fund it. And the research committee looks at whether is it viable. Do we have the funds? Do we have the collaborative ability to work with other people to fund the research? So it is a two-step process. It's very unique and robust. So we make sure that the money that comes in, that we're doing research that the members want.
Yeah. So let me ask you this. It's kind of a more general question than a specific ASRF question. Right now, why do you think chiropractic research is important?
Well, science and research are necessary forms of currency that our profession needs. And obviously, it equates to having a greater influence. So, and underpinning that is that research that is going to, A, define and help our profession move forward. So, there is research and there is chiropractic research. And so, I don't discredit, research that looks at, muscle activity and, how a manipulation or something like that, can actually, benefit, the human body. But with the ASRF, our research is vertebral subluxation research. And, the subluxation basically is a pillar and is a foundation of chiropractic. And so it is important that we do research that looks specifically at that, both at, defining and at how we can do it better, and also the benefits of chiropractic care for, as I said, human function, global well-being, and also quality of life.
Excellent. Another question was, recently, you put out, not you, the ASRF, put out a model for study for vertebral subluxation. The diagrams and definition, I was very enthusiastic. I still am very enthusiastic about. Can you talk a little bit about that?
So we have our vision is clear to understand the VS, and basically the diagram you saw was that the focal point was coherence. We spoke about, you know, you and I have spoken about coherence before, the importance of, you know, that it's looking at how the human chiropractic can improve the coherence in the human being.
Right. Mm. Right. And there was coherence, and it was that in the being of the person, and what were the other triangle circles? So it was I'm not looking at it right now.
I should know this, but yeah, I should actually get Hold on.
But I thought it was brilliant.
Yeah. Just keep talking.
That's okay. No problem.
Yeah.
So I was very grateful to participate in one of those. The United States, several of them. I got to participate in one in California, in San Francisco, which was very. I was honored to be in a room with such incredible people, and then that you. From the information you collected, came up with this model was something that was very good to be able to study, and very, very digestible, and also something that could go across many different chiropractic technique paradigms, I thought.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So it's not just, it's a definition and also an agenda that looks at the global scope of our profession. Absolutely.
Right. Okay. Yep. So with that, what are some examples? You being involved with the ASRF, how many years have you been involved?
I've been involved with the ASRF now for 5 years, as a board director. Yep.
In those 5 years, what are some exciting projects that you've seen the ASRF turn out?
So we've done, we've had research that's done by a lot by Heidi, so Heidi Horvick. So one of the great things is that we did that chiropractic care does impact pelvic floor control. So a great sort of, you know, breakthrough research that for women, you know, I've got up here. So, you know, greater strength, muscle function and less fatigue. So we did a research paper that looked at chiropractic care, how it can increase strength, decrease fatigue and improve the brain's ability to drive muscles. That was actually an amazing, once again, through Heidi. And then also there was a research paper that we did that adjusting the subluxated spine, how that changes brain function. And then in the older population, where a research paper that we published was that the chiropractic care can improve sensory and motor functions, which obviously are important for the elderly, especially when it comes to, you know, falls. That they're more prone to falling. So by improving sensory motor function, it reduces the fall risk, and that obviously impacts the quality of life for the elderly. So that's a lot. And then also. HIV. So, you know, recently, Dr. David Russell and Dr. Amy Haas, they did a paper that they show the improvements in HIV under chiro care. And that was actually a case series. Yeah. So, I mean, that for members and certainly for anyone looking at our research, we've got, pages and pages of papers that we've done and research projects that we've done. But they're some of the most recent and quite, you know, amazing ones that we've done.
Excellent. Excellent. Yeah. Now, you're going to be coming over from Australia to be at Mile High, August 16th to 19th. Also, David Russell will be coming over, which is very exciting.
Yes. Yeah.
I know you can't talk about what he's going to be sharing, but what are you going to be sharing?
Well, I'm going to be certainly sharing, I'm going to go a little bit more in depth about the foundation, and also giving people like an understanding as to, you know, what we actually do and why we should actually, you know, have an agenda for research, that, you know, it's often overlooked, you know, that, chiropractors in practice, they're busy, or they're trying to get busy looking after the community, spreading the word of chiropractic. Taking care of, you know, families and sports people and children, that kind of stuff. And at the end of the day, they need the research, because it's kind of where the rubber meets the road. You know, right. If someone comes in to see you and you say, look, you know, I can help you, that, you know, when you say that, you want to have that sort of, I guess, that that credibility, because underpinning that is the research. So it's so important. And that's why, you know, I travel the world, and I certainly thank you very much for your recent donation. And your constant support for the foundation. Your money goes to help us, you know, fund more research.
Well, and I'd like to say that really that I'm grateful to share that donation. Really, it comes from the attendees of Mile High. You know, when we run the event, a large portion of attendees' ticket sales go to a nonprofit each year. And this year, we're highlighting the ASRF because we really feel that the future of chiropractic hinges on research. We need to have more science. And people sometimes want to be in just, I want to talk philosophy and I know it works. We don't need science and innate rules and so on. But like we need research, right?
Yeah.
And I'll tell you, with what you just said, one of the things being a practitioner, because I practice every day, one of the things that I know is that the more science I'm familiar with, the more research I've read, even if I've just read the abstract of it, I don't have to have read the whole paper, but I get the conclusion of it. The more I do that, the more certainty I have. And when you have certainty in your practice, people get attracted to that. They know that you know, and it helps you serve more people. It helps people be confident in you. And I think that's not just a function of you're in practice for a number of years. It's a function of being familiar with the literature. And I'm not talking about you memorize stuff, but you're familiar with some of the incredible evidence we have for people's life changing with subluxation reduction.
Yeah. And our profession needs to be, I guess mature. Like, we're now in a world where, evidence, is required. And so it's, like we can't sort of hide under, the rocky, what we do, it works if, as long as you, believe that what I'm saying, that even though, and that's why, with the ASRF, we go in a direction that is going to foster the growth of the profession. But we do need evidence. We need more research. We need more research that's going to move our profession forward, and it's going to help us validate what we do, which we validate what we do every day in the practice. But we do require that certainty when it comes to research.
Absolutely. And that's why I'm grateful for it. That's why I'm grateful that you guys are sharing it at Mile High. And that's why at Mile High this year, a lot of the continuing education portions are focused on science and research, because I don't want people to come to a program where they just get spizzed up, though that's fun, right? I love hearing a great presentation that gets me fired up to go in the office on Monday. People need motivation, but I want people to also get content. I want them to feel like, wow, this is something I did not know about subluxation, and I feel like a better, more knowledgeable chiropractor with more certainty because of it.
Yep. And credit to you, you've put on amazing events previously, but this year, the caliber of speakers and presenters, my gosh, I'm a dum-dum compared to these guys. You spoke about Dave Russell. He is if you can excuse his his brashness and he's way more Aussie than I am. He is a genius when it comes to research. And then also Dr. Monique Andrews. You've got so really people that come to Mile High in August this year, they are going to get blown by just the amount of information, and also you're right, it's obviously very important for us to get spizz. It's important for us to get information and to learn and get inspired about how to build and how to improve your sales and marketing, and also the philosophy. But if you can leave the weekend going back to your office and going back to your own communities with that certainty about research, that's going to make a huge difference to you and also your community.
Right. And that was part of the vision of Mile High. Was I saw lots of the types of programs that were in our region of the country. I was like, this is the center of the U.S. And the types of programs were not helping people be stronger, more knowledgeable about chiropractic, subluxation, spinal analysis, etc. To get continuing education, they had to get something that was completely not chiropractic in my book. That's fine if those people have other focuses that they can do under the license, and I'm not judging that. I wanted to create an environment where people could strengthen their knowledge, information, understanding, of chiropractic, of subluxation, of spinal analysis, and be motivated, enthusiasm, and also increase their business strategy. So it's going to be great. And I'm so grateful to get to hear you on stage. You're going to be a great contributor to it. People are going to be very fortunate to be. And I'm going to tell people that when you come to Mile High, we are going to encourage you to become members of the ASRF. If you're watching or listening to this, maybe you're listening to an iTunes or you're watching it on the YouTube version. Don't wait till Mile High. Become a member of the ASRF now. And how do people do that? How do people support the ASRF?
Okay, so first of all, jump on our website. So it's www.spinalresearch.com.au. And if you there's a tab there to donate or to become a member. So people can either be a member, and there's different levels. The different levels allow you to participate, at a higher level or a lower level. Or you can also donate for a once-off donation. So, there's actually tabs there that will show you how to do it. Yeah, it's very, very simple.
So let me ask you this. What's the lowest level membership?
So the lowest form of membership is $40 a month, which is $40 Australian. So that's like, I don't know, like with the Australian dollar at the moment, it's probably about sort of $30 a month. Yeah.
Wow.
So.
So realize this. I have a certain philosophy or value system. For most people who are chiropractors, chiropractic has given them far more than they acknowledge that it has given them.
Yeah.
They think it's given them an income, and that may be true, right? It's given them a job and an income and a way of supporting their family. However, usually they themselves get their spine adjusted, okay, probably regularly, and they probably get that for free. They probably have some chiropractor that checks them free. From my case, my spouse, right? I don't have to pay for chiropractic care. My spouse checks me. My kids, I get to, because of the skill sets I have, I've checked them since birth. So I see how their health is compared to their, classmates, and it's so superior. We never go to doctors. They never get ill. We don't spend money in the medical paradigm because I know they've had the benefit of being subluxation free. If you think of what that is worth financially, that you're probably going to live a better quality of life and longer because you're a chiropractor, that most likely your kids and family are going to live a better quality of life and longer and avoid medical expenses. I mean, that's likely because you check them. Then the cost of the investment of giving $30, $40 a month to research in chiropractic is just kind of like, your dues. It's like paying for an adjustment. It's like paying to adjust your kids.
Absolutely. Right? And there's, as we all know, that it's always a balance that, you give something, you receive something. I get checked more regularly than once a month, but even if you just got checked once a month, and then you sort of use that as a way of actually paying forward, what's the average fee for a check in the US? Is it $50?
50-ish. There are people that charge 75 and those that charge 25, but $50 is a good average.
So if you, go out there and go, look, hey, I get checked, once a month, my spouse or, my local chiropractor that we check each other, we don't charge each other. But if they donate that check to the ASRF, if 1,000, US chiropractors did that, my goodness, the level of research, the level of certainty that we could gain, not just for the US, not just for Australia, but globally, because, we're expanding. And, when you think about, now over 100 years, we really should be expanding, further than we have. And, that if we can start that process of expansion because of the research and the certainty, it's going to make a massive difference. Don't you think, Danny?
Yeah. And that's how I want chiropractors to think about it. That's why I tell them at Mile High over and over again. And let's just say this, for whatever institution. Maybe it's a school. Maybe you want to donate to the New Zealand Chiropractic School or to Sharon College or Life West or the ASRF or the Foundation for Tubal Subluxation Research. Or all of those. I happen to donate to all of those because I feel like I get so much chiropractic, so much from chiropractic that I want to make sure I'm giving back. So like, and I get adjusted a lot. I've had the honor of being adjusted by Donnie Epstein since I was 18 for free. So like, how valuable is that?
You know? And that's very valuable, but doesn't Donnie get flown around to, you know, to check people?
Yeah. I mean, quite a bit. So and private jets and so and people spend a lot for him to spend a day with him, and he'll do that with us all the time. So like, I'm thinking he's not taking, you know, $50 a visit from me. I'm going to give that to chiropractic in some way. And my kids, like if people applied that level of thinking, all our research would be funded. And rather than us being in a lack place as practitioners or a lack place in research. And so when you come to Mile High, I want you to think that way. I'd like you to think, hey, man, I get so much from chiropractic. I can give something each month to research.
Yeah, absolutely.
So I'm very excited for you to be there. Is there anything last thing that you want to say to everybody listening about the ASRF?
No, just look, you know, we, any support is, you know, is welcomed. We'd love to, you know, have you on board. As I said, it's the ASRF, the Australian Spinal Research Foundation, but we're not just doing research for Australians. It's research for everyone. And look, you know, thank you, Danny, for inviting me to speak at Mile High. And let's just make this like, you know, like an amazing event. Like, you know, let's get it packed. Although you're saying that now it's, you know, it's starting to get, you know, like packed, isn't it? You've got, you know, a lot of numbers already attending.
Well, I'll tell you this, Mile High, it's, if you have not grabbed your seats, grab your seats, www.milehighcairo.org, August 16th to 19th. The hotel only has 215 sleeping rooms per night. It's a beautiful hotel. Everybody who comes there says one of the favorite things that they love is the level of service and how beautiful the hotel is. And that there's hiking trails and biking trails right off it, and incredible scenery and great places to eat near it. MileHighCairoHotel.com reserves your seat. Think about that, 215 rooms. We're going to have the whole hotel. Last year it sold out. So one, I recommend people register and also book your hotel room. Do not wait, because you don't want to stay at, you know, the Holiday Inn down the street, which you certainly could do, but you know, being where all the action is and there's breakout sessions and science panels, we're gonna do something different this year. Actually, I should say this. Yep. We're putting it together right now. Usually in the mornings we'll have a philosophy session. Every morning with like a panel and people asking questions. We decided that this year, because of the ASRF, we're going to have a subluxation science panel and have people ask science and research questions, which I'm super excited about. So like, if that's going to be early in the morning before the program, you don't want to be at another hotel and like have to come in there. The program is so full of information. It's you want to be on premises and you want to grab your seats before you can.
Yeah.
Good. So, excellent. Thank you so much for taking the time. I know it's super early for you down in Australia. I'm looking forward to going to Australia in a few weeks. And we look forward to having you here.
Pack some warm clothes, because it's pretty cool down there.
I've heard that. It's winter, so I've got to do that. And I'm going to also get to have good coffee. So, and I'll tell you, Billy, when you come here, you know, higher altitude, man, you'll notice it if you go for a hike or a run or you train. Yeah. So you'll feel it. So you got to make sure you hydrate when you're here. So
they don't thanks, Danny.
High for nothing. So everybody, thank you for listening to our podcast. And again, if you're listening to this iTunes or Stitcher or YouTube, make sure you hit subscribe so you never miss an episode. And we'll see you at Mile High August 16th to 19th. Like our page on Facebook, www.facebook.com/milehighcairo.